What I want is a nice press-headless lager. I don't have a podcast and I'm not a blogger, but I am on YouTube. Yeah, yeah, you're watching the Squatch and Brew, dude, 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 dude.
I've ever been to. I've been to 450 North probably about 4 years ago. This was the old tap room. Haven't been to the new sexy tap room. I was traveling down the John Mellencamp Highway. I was born in a small town and live in a small town. Damn, this is out in the middle of nowhere. They have, if I remember, they have good New England IPAs, and they had a little scandal with their smoothie sours. Very tasty, but I suppose there is no alcohol in them years ago, but let's see, let's go.
All right, the first one is the Happy Hour Nuggets, 8%. It's got Amarillo, Strata, and Mosaic. This is really good, really good. Nice earthy bitterness to it. It's got a little fruitiness, but not overly fruity. It kind of tastes more like a West Coast IPA. This is really solid. This is a really cool little place. I feel like I'm in a barn. I'll show you some more pictures. Really cool spot. I like this beer a lot. This is good.
This is where the sexy magic happens. Kind of funny. Walked in here and they were playing Pink Houses by John Mellencamp. Let's go. Columbus, Indiana. I got a flight. Got a trophy. Let's go.
All right. Let's go with the Helles. Dank Candy Gummy Haze. Got Simcoe, Centennial, and Mosaic. 6.5%. West Coast IPA, this is nice. I love Simcoe hops. A little bit of citrus, good bitterness at the end. Diesel, slushy. Supposed to take like blackberry, black currant, and boysenberry. It's a heavily fruited sour. 5.3%. This tastes, I'm tasting a lot of boysenberry. Very good. Really not sour at all. This is super sweet. Tastes like a smoothie. Tastes like wine punch. That's good. This is the Dank Candy. It's got Centennial, Simcoe, Mosaic, West Coast IPA, 8%. Very nice. A little bit of pine. Medium bitterness. This is really good. I'm kind of digging their beers here. Oh, Let's go. 420 juice remix. Triple dry hopped. We got Citra, Simcoe, Enigma, and Citra. Holy crap. Comes in at 10%. Tropical fruits. Get a little bit of melon. It's not too bitter. Pretty soft. Sorry, it doesn't taste like 10% at all. Kind of dank. I think I like their IPAs the best.
Hola, muchachos. Favorite one was the dank candy. Good times. I really, that's a cool spot inside there. Cool brewery. Here in Columbus, Indiana. Check it out.
I was born in a small town. I live in a small town. Probably die in a small town. Oh, those small communities.
Hola, muchachos. Where can I get a Squatchy Brew Dude t-shirt just like the Squatchy Brew Dude wears on Squatchy Brew Dude beer visits? Well, Squatchy Brew Dude Nation, here is your opportunity. Go to DC4LCustomTees.com. They also have a Twitter page, and you can get the latest and greatest t-shirt.
Hola, muchachos. I'm staying a real high-class joint, and they, as I checked in, they're like, you can get two free beers here. So there is a macro light beer that I have not had in years. It was one I would cringe when my neighbors say, hey, I got a beer. I know you don't like macro beer. Let's smell. Okay. I really don't get any hop presence from the nose. I smell basically nothing, maybe a little bit of corn. Okay, let's go. Let's see how it tastes. I get nothing. I get no hops. I get that's the only way to drink it. I'm really shitty at this. I could kill these in the day. Ask the people. Back in the day, I was the man, but that's horrible. Tastes like nothing. Don't know how people drink this. Don't know what the uproar is. All three brands are total garbage. You can do better. It wouldn't be so bad. Like, it doesn't, if they need to just add a little hops. Like, the beer flavor, it's not offensive. I've heard that before. It's not offensive. If there was like a little bit of hop character, I could drink this on occasion maybe, but you know. God, that was a pathetic chug. I haven't chugged in years. Sucks getting old. That was pathetic. Sucks getting old. You know, bring out the beer bong. Let's go. I went skydiving. I went Rocky Mountain climbing. I went 2.7 seconds on the pool named Fu Manchu. Let's go.
Hola, muchachos. Trying the Hop Static IPA here. Get fruit off the top. It's pretty good. Very fruity, but I get the tropical fruits, pretty smooth. A little bit of bitterness at the finish, but not crazy. I mean, you can tell you're drinking an IPA. Yeah, it's a little, you know, it's not crazy bitter, but there's bitterness. Yeah, it's pretty solid. West 6, baby.
Let's go.
Yeah, I'm kind of getting more in West Coast IPAs now, or just traditional IPAs. I don't know. My palate changes all the time. So, but I'm also been digging some lagers. Just been trying out. Usually I try to do that my first beer before my palate gets all crazy. Kind of like this class. Local beer tastes better sometimes. Had a local beer from a place yesterday. They had great pizza, beer. So a lot of people have given me a hard time because I usually say the beer's, yeah, it's really good. Yeah, that's great. But I go to a lot of bad breweries, more than I would care to. And I usually don't acknowledge that I went there. You know, I'm not going to put a bad brewery on their show. I was at a place recently. And I had been there before and I liked it and I was looking forward to going there, and two of the beers were really good and two of the beers were downright awful. I swear they're contaminated. One tasted metallic. Their Helles Lager was awful. And one of the, there was like some wheat beer named after some of the people that were involved with the brewery. And I was like, oh, I'll try that. And it just tasted just bad. It just tasted like something went wrong in the fermentation. But the other two beers were good. So I'm not gonna, you know, say, hey, oh, you did an awesome job, you know, if your beer sucks. So went to a place that yesterday, it was very watery, nothing fantastic. I want to like the place. I want to see everyone succeed, but if people need to go to brewing school and you know, I mean, everyone who starts brewing beer wants, it's a dream to open a brewery, but make sure you're ready, you know, make kick-ass beer. There's plenty of breweries now, you know, just make sure you do a good job. Watch Nate at Treehouse. Watch his videos. Learn something. Don't get, you know, complaints though. And there's a few guys that are, so whatever. Sorry.
Always have to stop and look at the sexy tanks. Here we are, West 6th, Lexington, Kentucky. The OG Lexington. Let's go. Pretty solid.
Hola, muchachos. I feel like I'm in San Diego. I'm here in the Beach Boys. It's like 76 degrees, almost have that San Diego breeze, except no palm trees.
Palm trees. I just want to see some palm trees. Let's go.
Still at West 6th. I'm drinking the, just a regular flagship IPA that they always have on tap. It's very good. A little on the fruity side. It kind of ends with a crisp, dry bitterness. It's good. Definitely, I can see why it's their flagship. Yeah, very, very drinkable, 7%. Filler word. Good vibrations.
So yeah, if you're in Lexington, West 6th is probably the place to start. It's kind of the OG of the Lexington brew scene. Ethereal is probably my favorite. These guys are really solid. Everything was really good. It's a cool brewery. If you're in Lexington, it's a must stop. Let's go. Cool place.
Wow. Being a beer slab in Arizona is pretty awesome. Got invited to the soft opening at Goldwater Brewing. Wow.
Hola, muchachos. I'm invited to the soft opening at Goldwater Brewing Company. And it's very soft. Drinking a Machine Gun Teddy 2017 brown ale, winner at the JBF. Pretty cool being a beer celebrity to get invited to these soft openings now.
That's cool.
Other more to come. The people that are flying around with ladders and trying to get everything ready for the grand opening tomorrow. So I'm trying to stay out of the way, low key, talking not very loud. Yeah. Goldwater. They got about 20 beers on tap. They brew in Scottsdale. This is the South Tempe location that's opening. They have another one, another taproom in Mesa. and it's real nice space, super nice. Check them out. The beer is fantastic. I've been to the Scottsdale one several times, and the Mason one once. Parking at the Scottsdale can be challenging sometimes, and it's kind of a small space, so they've kind of outgrown it, but that's where they brew for now. Let's go, digging it. Happy National American Craft Beer Week. Let's go.
Look at this sexy beer. I'm drinking a birthday suit. Just came out of the tanks today. Anything that's got Chinook is old school. It's calling my name. Citra, 907. Let's go. People of great beer. These guys, they hover around 5 or 6 in my favorite breweries in Phoenix. They're very good. And the cool thing is, they're even closer. The Scottsdale one, I really liked it a lot. And it's a cool spot. It just sometimes parking can be a little tough there. It's a little closer. Cool. Check these guys out. Awesome. Great beers. I really loved Birthday Suit. Was my favorite.
We're drinking beer on a Friday afternoon, facing a giant car wash. And the Scotchy Brewed dude is drinking his bottles of Goldwater. All I wanna do is have some fun. Kinda cloudy today, but hey, let's go. Thank you for watching.
Scotchy Brewed Dude Beer Visits, let's go!